The next teacher I wish to cover is George Ivanovich Gurdjieff. I regard him as one of the greatest mystics or teachers of the 20th century, and there's actually a very large amount of literature on him. It's quite possible there are as many as 100 books written about him. I have picked 3 books which I think will be a very good introduction to him. The first is In Search of the Miraculous, written by P.D. Uspensky, published in 1950. This book is quite interesting because Uspensky was a pupil of Gurdjieff between 1918 and 1922. He then broke away from Gurdjieff to found his own school in London. But on his deathbed, a manuscript was found which appeared to be a verbatim account of his 4 years of being a pupil of Gurdjieff's. This manuscript was read out in Russian to Gurdjieff, who said that this was an accurate account of his teachings, and it could be published eventually. This book is one of the all-time greats. The second book on Gurdjieff is Meetings with Remarkable Men, written by Gurdjieff himself, and first published in 1963. It gives you an account of the man's life and many things about him. This is a lovely book to read. The third book is Boyhood with Gurdjieff and Gurdjieff Remembered. I think they currently are all combined in Fritz Peter's Memoirs of Gurdjieff. These are very interesting because Fritz Peter's grew up as a boy in the family that surrounded Gurdjieff. At the time, he found himself there, not because he wanted to study, but because he was a child without parents, and very much saw Gurdjieff as a father figure. So he learned things about Gurdjieff's teaching which came from a different place, and his memoirs are of immense interest. I could speak a very long time on Gurdjieff, but this context requires me to be very limited. But what I can say is 3 things that I've picked. One thing about Gurdjieff, he was extraordinarily versatile. He was very unique, very entrepreneurial, and could turn his hand to anything. And in fact, in Meetings with Remarkable Men, there's a chapter called The Material Question at the end of the book, which was an account of how Gurdjieff earned money throughout his life. The second point is what Gurdjieff said about the purpose of life on earth. I think this is quite unique because he actually said that the earth occupied a rather dark quarter of the universe, and in understanding the purpose of life on earth, according to Gurdjieff, he spoke about two great laws that operated in the cosmos. One was the law of three, a kind of law of triads, and the second, the law of seven, which said that all processes that occurred on a microcosmic to macrocosmic scale did not occur in a linear fashion, but occurred with particular ups and downs, and these corresponded to the mi and fa and the si and do in the normal piano octave. Earth occupied a particular place in this octave, and the film of organic life that covered the earth was meant to deal with this particular aspect of the law. And really, the organic film of life received energies from the cosmos and created energies to send back to the cosmos. Now people, whether they lived or died, served this law. And this is quite a unique aspect, really, of what he said about the purpose of life. Third, Gurdjieff denied that people actually had free will. We think that we organize our lives, plan our lives, we organize it along conscious principles, we have a control over our future, and that we have free will. Gurdjieff said people have none of these things. In fact, life was what happens when we are busy making other plans. A deep understanding of this fact helps one approach his teaching.